Hello. Hello, lady. Hey, girly. Y'all doing okay? Enjoying your company? They think I came out here to feed them, but I didn't. Can y'all see how pink that sky is over there? That's probably a more accurate portrayal. So often I wish I had more ability to capture things well in video, like beautiful sunsets. It's dusk and I just decided I was gonna run back here and check on the mama pigs. I saw a little movement. I thought for a second that it might have been a baby, but I don't think it was. Well, they definitely nowhere to sleep. And they were all bedded down in there. Kind of feel bad for waking up pregnant ladies. Hey, y'all. Should have brought you some scraps. Close, but not yet. Don't bite my foot. All right, as you were. I'll see y'all in the morning. Good night. We finally closed up the trench here where we had done irrigation. You can see there's a spigot here where this can be hooked up to be watered, this in-ground garden. And there's not much going on here right now, but all these volunteers, like that's some sort of watermelon, more melon, lots of zinnias right here, and these beans. Oh, look at these Tabasco plants. They're covered. Still got a lot of flowers on them too. Tabascos have historically just produced so much for me. I've still got a lot of peppers and they're producing a good deal, but I wondered if these cool nights were gonna, you know, make them stunt at all, but so far they don't seem to be too bothered by it. I gotta do one thing really quick in the greenhouse before it gets dark. Hey girls, how are you? So I've got all these seedlings. Nana separated and thinned them some for me. But so I'm just trying to keep the soil moist. So I've been just watering with this hose. The irrigation does well to water deeply for plants that are established and have good root systems. But when you've got seeds coming up, seedlings have very shallow, small, undeveloped root systems, especially if you're transplanting them. And these right now just kind of shocked. They'll probably bounce back, no problem. But I just want to make sure that they can access water well, so that they don't dry up. Because if that very top layer of soil is dry, which can happen, especially in a high tunnel, on a sunny day, because even though it's not hot outside, it's warming up in here. And they can just shrivel up because they can't access water. Same thing over here. Now these are things that I just direct sowed, but they came up, and seedlings are just, it's so easy for them to dry up. So I just wanna make sure they're okay. I do love to see a bed full of seedlings. This space is gonna be so full of life here in no time. It already is back there. And this week has been such a good week. This summer was so intense. Obviously, it's been a pretty emotionally charged year for a lot of us. A lot of plans changing and not knowing exactly what was gonna happen. And the thing that we decided to do this year, I mean, almost immediately as everything started to unfold in March, was kind of my answer to any situation where I feel unsure about what to do. I really don't ever want to place fear on the throne of my life, but there are definitely seasons and situations where there's uncertainty, and you might have faith that the outcome will end up being okay, but you still don't know what to do and what's gonna happen. And I don't consider that weakness. I consider that humanity, really. But the thing that we really settled on doing whenever we would pray about everything when COVID first started to happen was just do what's in your hands. And that's kind of where that whole turn your waiting room into a classroom sentiment comes from. It's like when there's so much more you wish you could do, and there's so many ideas that you have, and so many things that might be out of your control in a situation, just do what you can right now, like what's in your hands, what's in front of you. Hey, can I have that bucket? Why aren't y'all getting in bed? It's late. Here's the early bedtime birds in here. And all you busters sleeping in the nest boxes. Hey, back up. You are not a hen. They're eggs. Alpacas don't eat eggs. Alpacas don't eat eggs. Neither do goats. Goats don't eat eggs either. Go on with your pee face. I'm getting out of here. I narrowly escaped love rubbins from Dr. Ennis and his pee face. So when the COVID stuff happened, started, there's so much contradicting information. Nobody knew what was going on. We just knew that it was kind of an unprecedented situation. Ryan and I spoke about it and we were like, we're just gonna do what's right in front of us. We're gonna grow food, teach people how to grow food. Hey bud, what's up?
What are you doing?
Making a video, what are you doing? I'm working, yeah. Just making a video. I'm just walking around in the evening. I just got some eggs out of the coop. See ya.
Well, I don't have anywhere to go.
Well, come sit down here then. And for us, that's what we did. We grew food and we taught people how to grow food and we kind of just really did that a lot. And it turned out to kind of be the theme of this summer in a really big way. Was, you know, I was writing the book, the gardening book that's coming out in February. I wrote that largely through this spring and summer. A lot of it after like the COVID stuff started. And then of course we produced a lot of content. We worked on a lot of different projects and some more things that are actually still coming up that you guys don't know about yet. And that's just been the theme of this year. And as the season has begun to change, it's been a really sweet thing. And this week, the leaves are starting to change. It's getting cool. It's very cool in the mornings. You know, I'm like really prepared for the fact that the garden's about to die back. We have so much new life on the farm, like so many, you know, babies coming. I talked about that the other day. We've got goats breeding and settling and our pigs are due any day. And it's just this sense of overwhelming goodness. I don't know, I'm just really thankful for it. It's funny how in situations that feel really big and scary, a lot of times we can become really overwhelmed, but really the way through is just the, you know, the small thing that's right in front of us, the next step, you know, the next step of the path is already, it's already lit. And I'm so excited for what's next. I don't even know that I have language for it, but I imagine at some point I'll probably look back at this video and it'll be one of those aha things, you know, like where you look at it and you go, wow, you felt that was coming, but I don't know. I don't even really know why I wanted to share it with you guys. Maybe just because the evening walks in fall get me in my feelings. What you got there, bud?
A rake.
A rake? I gotta be careful not to break these because there are so few of them in there. Look at these dahlias. Aren't these extraordinary? Oh, they're so pretty. This is the third year that these have come back and they always really peak here at the end of the season. So lovely. And these guys were surely lovely while they lasted. And kind of on the tail end, they're still beautiful. Still adding color.
Right?
What'd you say?
You have to pick those quick.
Have to pick them?
Yeah.
You think we should pick them and take them in the house?
Before they die.
Well, you want to?
Yes.
Ben, you are the workingest child I ever knew. Me too.
I'm trying to clean up, Mommy.
You're cleaning up?
Yeah.
Thank you. Maya is really better at the flower arranging. He always picks an array of things and puts them together and makes them look really pretty. When I make a bouquet, it's always just a handful of flowers in a pickle jar, but that's okay. That's a farm girl bouquet. And I think they'll be just fine. Thank you guys for hanging out with me today. As you can see, it's dark. Sometimes I wish I had better words to convey exactly what I'm feeling. But right now, this week, just kind of looking back on the culmination of this year and the passing away of this season as the trees kind of prepare to go out in their blaze of glory and we pass into the winter season, this time for rest, I've just been very reminiscent and I'm very thankful. I know I'm saying it over and over again, but sometimes maybe it needs to be said. Thank you for hanging out with me. I bless you. Until next time.